What's up, vinyl community? Cliff the Vinyl Cheapskate here. Missed the last couple Fridays for you guys. I don't know how many people actually follow my videos all the time, but I usually do a Friday video and I missed the last two. I was on vacation 1 week, and this week we have a friend visiting. I'm doing an early morning Saturday. Cheers. Doing my coffee music, which I'll post what I'm listening to on Instagram too, but listening to the Procol Harum, Salty Dog. It's like one of my favorite albums of all time. And bought this double, it's a double LP with Procol Harum, Whiter Shade of Pale on the other side. But this is sick, great album. But this isn't what I'm doing today. Today I'm doing a pickups video. Filled a bunch of holes in the collection. So this is just pickups video of stuff that I've been meaning to pick up and or gaps in things that I've been collecting a lot of. So before we get any further, I'll show you what we, you know, take a sip of coffee and show you some records that I've got that are filling holes in my collection. Well, first off, I'll start off with just some like classic Japanese hardcore stuff. This Crow record here. Yeah, I forget what the name of the thing is, but it's all in Japanese. It's like Beating Wings of something. But it's on Prank Records. Crow picture disc. Sleeves got the same cover art. This is a cool apocalyptic sounding, like kind of crusty Japanese punk hardcore album. And sounds good for a picture disc, but this is a great, great record. Crow's an awesome band, just in general. I think they're a little not underappreciated if you like Japanese hardcore. Next up, this one needs no introduction. Everybody's gonna know what this is, but I didn't have a copy. I had some other Black Flag stuff, but I didn't have this one. Black Flag Damaged. And this is a early repress. It's like 1984 or something like that. Extra Angry Henry there. We got our Extra Angry Henry on there. Yeah, not much you can say about this. Just total classic record. And this was a huge gap that got filled. And I'm super excited just to have any copy of this in my collection. And I got this for like the price of a modern repress. So I was excited to get this. Great record. This is, yeah, one of the best albums of all time. Not just Black Flag, just albums, period. Now, another one. That's a huge gap that, this isn't an original. I can't afford an original. This is a bootleg of some sort, but Black Sabbath, Headless Cross. I've been meaning to pick this up forever, and every time I find it, I'm priced out. This is a white vinyl repress. I think it sounds great. For what it is, I mean, it's a bootleg, but it's a good, I think it's a well done one. It's out of my league. But here's the thing, this is a great album, but if you're looking for like Ozzy era Black Sabbath, this ain't it. But I like it. I think it's a great 80s, got great 80s metal production on this thing. It just sounds really good. But I like this album. This is one of my favorite Tony Martin era albums, I think. I think it is my favorite Tony Martin era album. Alright, so now we're getting into the, well, I'll do one more that's a one-off. Pick this up. High Roller is re-releasing all the Manila Road stuff, so I'm gonna slowly start picking all these up. Very excited to have this. This sounds really good too. Came with a bunch of cool stuff inside. High Roller does a really great job on their releases. But this is my favorite Manila Road album, The Dolch. I love this album. People may disagree with me. I don't know where that stands with most people, but that's my favorite one. Came with the this here. This is High Roller, like old school, like not order form, but the old school where they print out their entire catalog on like an insert and put it in there. They got one of those in there, which is pretty cool. Pretty cool throwback deal. Lyric sheet with some cool artwork on it. Yeah, it's got some nice artwork on there. Little lizard with a fork. You gonna need a snack, maybe? Mill Road, like, big postcard with a picture of the band. And came on clear blue, bluish, clearish vinyl. High Roller does a great job. I'm gonna keep an eye out for more of their stuff. I think I'm also gonna pick this up. Pick up more of these. They'll be in more videos later. Like I said, this is my gap filling. I've needed Manila Road in my collection for a long time. That's why this is a gap. I don't have any other Manila Road, but I'm happy that these are getting repressed so I can pick them up slowly. Hold on, I'm missing one. Hey. Give me one second. Alright, so I got one more one-off I almost forgot about, but this was one that I've been on a search for this for the last, like, 2 or 3 years, and I couldn't even find represses that were in the United States and affordable, but I found one now. It took me a while, but I got one. Hard Stuff Bulletproof. This is one of the best, like, just straight-up hard rock albums I've ever heard. It's so good. But I think this is essential if you're into like 70s, like hard rock, like proto metal stuff. This is like an essential album. Excellent stuff. Paul Hammond, John Cain. I mean, John Gustafsson, just like, this is killer. Killer power trio, heavy as hell. Hard rock stuff. Came with this cool insert poster thingy. But that's all it came with. And, oh, it came with a CD version too that... is it in here? Did I put it in here? I don't know exactly. Where the hell did I put that? Oh, there it is. Yeah, it came with a CD version too. So I can listen to it in my car. Pretty sweet. Excited about this. It sounds good. I listened to it. It sounds really good. And last, but definitely not least, some things I've been missing, sorely missing from my Bathory collection. Nuclear War Now had just got like a big group of Bathory records, and I just kind of went ham on them because I was like, you know what? These are all things I've wanted for 10 plus years, and I've just been slacking on picking them up. They're always like a little pricier than I want them to be, which this is no exception. They weren't cheap, but that it was still worth it. I got Bathory under the sign of the Black Mark, so now I have all the classic like albums up until... This was the only one I needed to get where they were still like doing black metal. You know what I mean? They didn't go into the whole Viking metal spiel that they went on, which I love that stuff too, don't get me wrong. But this was the last one I needed to fill that for the first four albums, where they're still like pretty much a straight up black metal band. But this is their most straightforward black metal album, and Bathory has been one of my favorite bands forever. So I'd like to get all their studio albums. I think I'm going to start doing ranking videos eventually, and I'm going to do ones that I have big chunks of the discographies for. Like, I want to do a Judas Priest one, and probably a Bathory one as well. Because I have enough Bathory now that I could do a ranking video, I think. But next up, I got Bathory Blood on Ice, which is an excellent Viking metal album. There's some cheesy parts on this, but at the same time, when I'm listening to like Viking metal stuff, I expect a little bit of cheese, and this delivers all over. Like, this album's really growing on me since I got it. And I used to like Hammerheart more, but I think I like this album more now because I've been listening to it so much. And it's just a really great album. If you think you don't like the Bathory stuff because when you were younger you listened to it, the early Bathory stuff, and then it was like not exactly the death metal, black metal stuff, you know, the black metal, thrashy black metal stuff that is only really the first four albums, then that might not be for you, but the Viking Bathory metal stuff is on point. And then last, I got this one. They went back to like the thrashier sound. This is not my favorite. It's kind of like, I feel like it was like a slightly generic-ish album. I haven't listened to this one a ton, truthfully. I need to listen to it a couple more times to get a solid idea on what it is, but I'm happy to have this in the collection. I need to find Requiem as well, but super excited just to have all these awesome Bathory albums in my collection. Oh, I didn't show the vinyl on the, hold on, I didn't show the vinyl on this. This is a red. This is a red vinyl version of this double LP red vinyl. This is Blood on Ice. But excellent, excellent album. The Blood on Ice and the Under the Sign of the Black Mark are some of my favorites. But yeah, that's what I got. I'll have another one soon-ish, probably later this week, because I've got even more stuff that I didn't show in this video, just for time. I don't want to make this a super long video. But enjoy that Procol Harum in the morning, man. Procol Harum, Salty Dog, check that album out. Cheers, Mama Community. Have a good one.